Peace be unto you and your family. 11th chemistry refresher course model unit 11 solution. And now we are going to discuss about the answer key in means of students activity and assessment. First come to students activity. Only one student activity questions we have. One is list out the physical nature of solute and solvent in the following solutions. We know a solution is made up of two components, one is solute and another one is a solvent. Solvent is a large proportion in which solute is present in very smaller proportion. Keep this in mind. Come to the types of solution. One is soft drink. Soft drinks seems to be liquid in which gas, carbon dioxide gas is present. So the smaller quantity gas is dissolved in liquid. Second one is tea. Tea seems to be a liquid in physical state, but it containing some solid. And alloys, we know mixture of metals, mixture of metal and non-metal. Solid in solid solution is alloys. Air is a mixture of gases, oxygen in nitrogen, nitrogen in noble gases, etc., etc. And cloud, the gases, large proportion is gas and in which liquid molecule is present, that is called cloud. Come to the assessment part of this solution unit. First question. How will you classify the solutions based on the amount of solute? Whether solute is present in smaller quantity or larger quantity? Saturated solution. No more solute can be dissolved in a definite amount of solvent at a given temperature. If you add more solute, it gets precipitated in the vessel itself. That is saturated solution. Unsaturated solution, it contains less solute than that of the standard solution at a given temperature. Saturated solution. So unsaturated solution, it contains less solute than that of the saturated solution at the given temperature. We can add more solute in unsaturated solution. Super saturated solution, it contains more than the maximum amount of solute that is capable of being dissolved at the given temperature. Being unstable, crystals form when it is disturbed. So saturated solution is a common. If the amount of solute is less than saturated solution, it is called unsaturated. More than saturated solution, it is called super saturated solution. Come to the second assessment part. Write notes on factors affecting solubility of a solute. Solubility is a measure of how much of a solute can be dissolved in a specified amount of a solvent. Solubility is equal to mass of the solute by mass of the solvent into 100. For example, the solubility of sodium chloride in water is 36 gram at 25 degrees Celsius. What are the factors affecting solubility? First one is nature of solute and solvent. Polar compounds, the compounds in which containing a plus and minus charges, are soluble in polar solvent like water. Water is a polar solvent, universal solvent. And non-polar compounds are soluble in non-polar solvent like ether, acetone, benzene, chloroform and etc. For example, sodium chloride, Na plus Cl minus, is a polar compound dissolved readily in polar solvent like water. Sodium chloride, Na plus Cl minus, is dissolved in water. Hydrogen less electronegative element, tel plus, oxygen is more electronegative element, 2 tel 2 minus. A polar compound is soluble in the polar solvent. Come to the second factor affecting effect of temperature. Solubility of solids in liquids increases with the increase in temperature. Endothermic process in which heat is absorbed. Solubility increases with the increase in temperature. Exothermic process in which heat is liberated, given out. Solubility decreases with the increase in temperature. Solubility of gases in liquid decreases with the increase in temperature. This is gases. Come to the third factors affecting effect of pressure. When pressure is increased, the solubility of gas in liquid increases. This process is used by dissolving gas in liquid in all soft drinks. Come to the third assessment part. Will the cool drinks give more fish at top of the hills or at the foot? The cold drinks will give more fish bubbles at the top of the hill because the fish is created due to the excessive pressure released, which is chilled inside the bottle for carbonation using carbonic acid. Now, the pressure release procedures intensity is dependent on external environmental pressure. When the internal and the external pressure are same, the procedure will stop. Now, in the hill top, the external pressure is very low, and that's why the pressure difference is very high, which causes a strong fissing process. Yes, because solubility of gases are less at a high altitude, hence the carbon dioxide is less soluble in cold drinks at altitude and give more fish. Come to the fourth assessment part. In what way hygroscopic substances differ from telecussent substances? Hygroscopic substances, when exposed to the atmosphere at ordinary temperature, they absorb moisture and do not dissolve. Here, when exposed to the atmospheric pressure at ordinary temperature, they absorb moisture and dissolve. Hygroscopic substances do not change its physical state on exposure to air. For example, concentrated sulfuric acid, silica gel, used as an adsorbent, used as a dehydrating agent. And here, telecussent substances, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, pellets are placed on the table, exposed to the atmosphere, it dissolves, it is converted into a liquid, exothermic reaction. My dear students, in this video, we discussed the answer key unit 11 solution topic. We also discussed the students' activity and assessment. Thank you for watching. Thank you. Thank you very much.